My name is Dr. Melissa Starling, and I've just finished a PhD at the Veterinary Science Faculty at the University of Sydney. I looked at optimism in dogs. So I was looking at whether dogs expect more positive outcomes in their life or more negative outcomes. So the characteristics of an optimistic dog, they're quite happy to take risks because they expect that it will probably pay off for them. And they're also quite persistent because, again, they just expect that if they keep trying, eventually something good will come out of it. They're not nearly so fragile, so when something bad does happen, they tend to just pick themselves up and keep going. The characteristics of a pessimistic dog is that they're quite risk averse, so they don't want to put themselves out there and try new things in case it turns out badly for them, because that's what pessimism is. You expect that things are going to turn out poorly. So, you know, they don't like to try new things. You know, if they don't get rewarded when they expect to get rewarded, for example, they might find that quite distressing. They learn a discrimination task where they discriminate between a tone that means they're going to get a milk reward and a tone that means they're going to get water instead. Once they've learnt that discrimination, then we give them tones that are ambiguous, so they're between the milk and water tones they've already learnt. And we're interested in how they respond to those tones, because that would tell us whether they interpreted that as a positive signal or a negative signal. If we know how optimistic or pessimistic a dog is normally, then we can keep a track of whether that changes over time. So if an optimistic dog becomes less optimistic, then that might be a concern for their welfare, because we might assume that their emotional state is becoming more negative. What we found out from working with Assistance Dogs Australia, they train service dogs for disabled people, and we found out that a lot of their dogs that are actually doing well in training are more pessimistic than optimistic. You might imagine that you know, search and rescue dogs or detection dogs or something like that might do better if they're more optimistic. So if you wanted to make a pessimistic dog more optimistic, you might look at teaching them to be more persistent by, like, giving them lots of rewards for, you know, just trying things out. And, you know, it doesn't mean that they have to do things right. If you just reward them for just trying, then you might teach them to persist with things and then find rewards in lots of different places. So the great thing about this research is that it's an objective way to assess animal welfare, but it's also very non-invasive, and it's applicable to any manner of species.